Today we will see heterosis or hybridity vigor. So in this chapter we will see what is heterosis and why it is important in case of crossbreeding or outbreeding. So it has been seen that crosses of animals from different strains or lines of the same breed, or from different breeds or from different species, will result in offspring whose level of production is above that of the average of the parents. That means, okay, whenever we are crossing two animals from two different breeds, or two animals from within breed, or two animals from different species, so the resultant offspring will have performance more than the average performance of both the parent. For example, suppose one male is having capacity to produce 5 liter of milk, whereas female is producing 6 liter of milk. So the average production in this way will come around 5.5 liter. However, when we are going for mating of these two individuals, the resulting progeny will have production of more than 5.5 liter. Let us say it as 6 liter. So this 0.5 liter over and above the production of average of the parent is called as heterosis or hybrid vigor. And it has been seen that, or it has been assumed that this increase in production, it may be due to increased fertility, increased pre and postnatal viability, that means ability to sustain life, faster and most efficient growth, improved mothering ability also. It has been seen that in crosses, mothering ability has been increased. This increased level of performance as compared to the average of the parent, the increased level of performance in comparison to the average of both the parents is known as heterosis or hybrid vigor. So we can see that this heterosis can be either positive or negative. Why it will be positive or negative? Suppose in case of AFC, the desirable direction is negative. If AFC is reducing, it will be better for a farm. So in that case, heterosis may be negative. Heterosis is the phenomena in which progeny of crosses between inbreed line or pure breed population exceed the average of the two parental population. So it is a phenomena where two inbreed line, if we are crossing two inbreed line, the resulting progeny will cross the average performance of these two lines. Or same can be applied to the pure breed population. So here also progeny will exceed the average of the two parental population. So if you remember the inbreeding depression from last class, here we can say that inbreeding depression is just opposite to the heterosis or hybrid vigor. So hybrid vigor is just opposite to inbreeding. So next we'll see how we can measure the heterosis. So heterosis can be measured by a formula, which is heterosis can be depicted by letter capital H, and it will be equal to mean of the F1 offspring minus mean of the parents divided by mean of the parents into 100. That means the average superiority of the F1 offspring over both the performance of average of both the parents. So here I have given one example, the mean litter size at weaning in pig. So in breed A it was 7, in breed B it was 8. So mean of these two, A and B, will be around 7.5. But it has been seen that F1 offspring is having mean litter size of 8.5. So heterosis will be the mean of F1 offspring, that is 8.5, minus mean of parent 7.5, divided by mean of the parent, that is 7.5. That means ki 1 by 7.5, 0.133, that is 13.33%. So here the heterosis or hybrid vigor achieved is 13.3%. There are many types of heterosis which has been recognized in animal breeding. So few are given here. The first one is parental heterosis. Parental heterosis consists of both maternal and paternal. Parental heterosis consists of both maternal and paternal. That means ke heterosis achieved due to mother effect or heterosis achieved due to father effect. Then another one is individual heterosis, which refers to non-parental performance, where the performance of parent is not considered. The third one is heterosis due to non-additive gene action. So we'll see in the coming slides that what are these type of heterosis. So coming to the next, we'll see what are the genetic basis of heterosis. Why heterosis occurs? What are the genetic explanation of this heterosis? So that there are some theories that have been put forwarded for the explanation of heterosis. In that, the first is dominance theory. Dominance theory, it postulates that the paternal line are homozygous dominant for both the loci. So what it postulates ki paternal line is homozygous dominant for different loci, when crossed produce progeny with dominant gene at all loci. So suppose ki we are having a maternal line. In maternal line, few genes are dominant homozygous and few other genes are recessive homozygous. So some genes are dominant homozygous and some genes are recessive homozygous. In opposite, in another maternal line, the genes which is dominant in paternal line is here recessive in maternal line, recessive homozygous in maternal line, and gene which is recessive in paternal line, here it is dominant homozygous in maternal line. So if we cross these two individual, the resulting progeny will be having both almost all the genes as heterozygous. So this heterozygous will behave like homozygous dominant phenotypically. So the production that we will achieve from heterozygous will be similar to as that of the dominant homozygous. So in progeny, all the locus will have heterozygous genotype. So definitely there will be increase in the production in comparison to both maternal and paternal parents. Then second one is overdominance theory. Overdominance theory, it assumes that the heterozygous is superior to either homozygous. So what they are telling ki overdominance, that means ki when genes are coming in heterozygous position, there are certain reaction that is taking place between homozygous dominant and recessive alleles, that it will be having performance better than both the homozygotes. So that is called as overdominance, and the people are advocating that crossbreed is showing the properties of overdominance. That is why the crossbred progeny will have performance better than both the parents. Another one is epistasis theory. It postulates that gene interactions are responsible. So epistasis, as we have studied epistasis in unit 2, there you might have seen that when epistasis is solely the phenomena of epistasis will occur based on the composition of alleles present on different locus. not on the same locus, because phenomena of dominance is occurring based on the alleles present on same locus. Converse to that, phenomena of epistasis occurs because of the genes or alleles present in different locus or neighboring locus. So it is postulated that when we are crossing two individual opposite genetic combination or opposite allelic combination, when we are crossing it, most of the there will be formation of new combination, and new combination will show more phenomena of epistasis, and that is why the production level will be increased in case of progeny. So these are the genetic basis of heterosis. In that, first one was dominance theory, second was over dominance theory, and third was epistasis theory. So whenever you are asked in examination to write what are the genetic basis of heterosis or what are the causes of heterosis, genetic causes of heterosis, you have to write this theory, these three theories. So generally, all the quantitative characters are governed by many genes, and no animal is likely to carry all of them in heterozygous dominant state. So we all know that quantitative traits are governed by many genes. Okay, so and it is also assumed that all of the means a particular individual will not carry same genotype on all the loci. So at some locus there will be homozygous dominant, at another locus it will be heterozygous dominant, at another locus it will be homozygous recessive. So in living organism, dominant genes are more often favorable than the recessive gene. We all know that dominant genes are more favorable, that means ki dominant gene is having upper hand in production or performance, so that is why it will be more favorable with the by the animal owner or animal rearer. Crossing of two different line or breeds has a greater chance of contributing different dominant genes to progeny. So when we are crossing two different line or breed has a greater chance of contributing different dominant gene to the progeny. So just see in this example, we can see that in first individual, the gene combination gene or allele combination are capital AA, small BB, small CC, small DD, capital DD and small E. That means ki it is having two pair of dominant genes. Similarly, the animal B or individual B, where you can see capital small AA, capital BB, small CC, small DD and capital E. Here also two pair of genes are dominant, but this is not similar to the first individual. So both these individual is having different dominant genes at different locus. But when we are crossing these two individuals in F1, you can see that four loci will be having at least one allele dominant. That means ki four loci will be heterozygous, so automatically production will be increased in F1 progeny. So this is about heterosis. Next we'll see ki how we can breed individual, how we can breed individual for the purpose of exploiting the heterosis or utilizing the heterosis. So to exploit heterosis, lines or breeds with good nicking ability or combining ability are crossed. So here question comes, what is nicking ability? So nicking ability means ki how, which two lines or which two breed will combine well, that you have to test, and on the basis of test result you will be able to exploit the heterosis or hybrid vigor. So the combining ability can be determined only by test cross. So this is not the test cross that we have studied. This test cross means ki you have to test between the two lines or two breeds ki which two lines will combine well or which two lines will nick well.
A breeder attempting to produce lines which will combine well with each other has to produce large number of lines. So whenever a breeder want to see ki which two lines will combine best, so for that he or she has to produce many lines and has to combine these lines, and on the basis of result of performance of the progeny, he will decide ki which two lines are nicking well or combining well. Then he can test them in crosses and find those which give best results. This idea is expensive. So producing all these lines and maintaining them and then crossing and then assessing the performance of progeny, it is very tedious and it will take more time and money. So as a general rule, the lines or breed totally unrelated give better heterosis in crosses. So what a breeder will assume ki lines which are not related, the lines which are not much related, less related, they will combine well or give better result. So there are many ways by which you can assume ki which one will give better results based on our reading, our understanding about the breeding or genetic composition of the animals. So one is that the unrelated individual will give better heterosis in crosses. Then there are two types of combining abilities. So to know the combining ability, which line will combine best, so there are two type of combining ability. So what is combining ability, that also we will see, but first we will see ki what are the two combining ability. The first one is general combining ability and second one is specific combining ability. So these two combining ability we have to consider when we will use heterosis or we will exploit heterosis while doing crossbreeding. So these two GCA and SCA and combining ability and related portion we will see in the next class. Thank you.